The three Akwa United will take on Nasarawa United, while Warri Wolves will play Enyimba. That's for the first leg.
Yeah, we hear that the second game will be a late fixture. That's the one between Akwa United, I think. It will be late because of our China engagement against Tunisia.
Okay, so that's the update for the MPFL Super 4. We're counting down. We're looking forward to it. It's a good one for our teams and playing in the continent to prepare for that competition. So, the league is already in our face. That's right. Let's just hope that everything goes according to plan. Before we go into that WADA report that is getting everyone talking, let's just talk about this bans under to Real Madrid and Atletico Madrid.
I mean, yeah, FIFA just going tough on those two clubs for transfer of minors. You know, it's been happening in football. You know, there's a kind of change these days. People recognize that you can start playing football at a tender age and you can give your best at that. But FIFA is coming down hard. Two transfer window bans for Real and Atletico. It's not going to affect them for this January.
Okay.
But two that's going to be in the summer and next January. So we see all of these clubs, how they react. Remember what just happened to Barcelona. They bought two key players. Those players just started playing in the new year. So we're going to see how all of this do happen. Clubs now need to be careful with how they do business. Some of these things will not escape the notice of FIFA.
So
FIFA are trying to monitor what is going on, especially with minors.
That's right.
You have to really take them seriously, ensure that your books are clean and you don't do what is called under the table deals, because that's what is getting these clubs into this.
Well, we'll get to know more, Wally, but it shows that FIFA, they are watching, and then again, Nigeria, that's what we should also look into. Remember the Nigerian Football Federation, they're bringing out policies that will guard against all of these, because it's about time we keep rogue agents at bay.
Guess what? The one you talked about, the Nigerian angle, I think is just mouth talk. I just think it's lip service. For all of we've said about protecting our young players, we've never acted upon it. In fact, the AG, the Act, I think is one of the 10-point I think in the next 3 to 5 years, the next AG, you see that
you could write it down. Yeah.
They won't do anything. So, but on the world stage, I think that it's really good that Barca don't think they're scapegoats, because it happened to Barca, they thought they're scapegoats. But right now, it's happened to a direct rival, and they'll be really happy at that one. but for Real and Athletic, good news is that they can sign players, but they can't register them. So they can sign players in June, they can sign players in January, but they can't play. Just like it happened to they can't play. And also, the good news also is that Real can appeal this ban and still continue to sign players and register players. But FIFA will also argue that you have enough time between now and the next transfer window to appeal to know if your appeal will be successful or not. So Real and Atleti will need to employ the very best of lawyers to ensure that they're successful.
I sense that there might be a flurry in January for those two clubs. Look, if we're going to have problems in June and the next
January is almost over. They need to work
back. Start getting players.
It's a big thing, because check out Real. They're looking at Paul Pogba. They can't do that anymore. They're looking at probably selling off Karim Benzema. They can't do that anymore. There's David De Gea also. Maybe Eden Hazard wants to move to Real Madrid. They can't do that anymore. So you just check
when
it
they
out.
Show interest in players. Those clubs want them to pay through their nose because they know the kind of situation that they are
But there's a positive. The positive is that Real now are forced to look in within. You have to bring your players from within.
I'm not sure I would want to sign for Real Madrid now if I know that I sign, I might not play for next 8-9 months.
That's right.
It's risky.
That's the downside, but it's Real Madrid and you just go for training, you chill your bank account. It's getting sad every day. You want to do that also. Okay, let's go over to the International Athletics Federation, the IAAF. There it is, the Ethics Commission in FIFA. It is the Ethics Committee. They are working really hard here, and then more revealing starts coming out of that one.
It's more than the Ethics Committee, IAAF. They even have an independent investigative chamber, whatever you want to call it.
It's a serious
the pound is involved in that one. They're so independent that nobody even looks. Nobody breathes down their neck, nobody breathes down their shoulder. The IAAF president's given them free hand to do, and a lot of people are going to go down.
Wow.
The former president, they said under his watch, a lot of things were going wrong, that he helped Russia to cover up a whole lot of things. They said his personal advisor, lawyer and friend, Abib Sissé, I think, was involved in the cover-up. We also heard the French police thinking of picking up his son. That's Lamine Diak's son. I mean, a whole lot of things. And, you know, WADA...
After giving them live bans.
WADA told us to expect a lot today that what we saw in the previous days...
Preamble.
You know, and the IAAF was ready today because they know that the things that will come out will rock their world. And it's really happening. Heads are going to roll. Hmm. A lot of things. And it was a systemic rot. The revelations are saying that it came from the top.
Wow.
That as high as a former president calling the shots, what should be done, what should not be done, how to cover up a whole lot of things. I don't know where IAAF will go from this. Separately, the ethics committee also working, thinking of people to give bans, fines, who the police should pick up.
Still working, doing a lot of research, who is involved, who is not involved. And that makes me come to you, Olawale. It has to do with doping, which is a big enemy
doping
to the
and corruption.
And corruption.
Yeah, doping is corruption.
Which is a very big enemy to sports whatsoever. Yeah. Big work for Sebastian Coe, big work for international athletics, more so for Africa. We need to start sensitizing our athletes.
Yeah, as long as Coe gets linked to Nike, I don't think all of this will go away. Remember, all of this started with his relationship with Nike Oregon got the rights towards the world championship.
But these guys have given him the backing.
Yeah, but that's my problem. I think
they're still looking at
it. I think if the independent commission headed by Dick Pounder are saying that a whole lot happened under Coe when he was also vice president. And
they're still backing him.
And they're still backing him. I'm really, because you look at the statement, they said there was no political will or political appetite, that's the word used, to ensure that they chase.
And that the leader was too powerful.
Yeah. And guess what? They also used the word. They called them the likes of Lamine Diak and his son miscreants. Mm-hmm. And guess what? The likes of Seb Coe were spared. So I don't think that Coe should go freely on this. But since they've backed him, I think that they want a clean break. And maybe Coe might just be the one leading them in this clean break because a whole lot has happened. And they can't afford to start 2016 on a very, very wrong note. 2015 was a rough year for athletics. And is Coe the right man? I think he is.
Yeah.
But last week, his Deputy General Secretary resigned, Nick Davis. Since the signs are not just good.
Yeah.
But I just hope that they can overcome this rough patch and... probably WADA stops releasing all of these reports.
That's right. As a former athlete, I think Coe understands the fight.
Yeah.
He has also seen the need to bring back the integrity of the sport. And
yeah, it's very important.
But the important thing in all of this is that there's a fight going on that is geared towards making athletics, world athletics,
better.
And Africa should start looking at ways and start looking inwards now because we said it after Russia, I'm sure they're heading for Kenya.
Yeah.
And after Kenya, they might just say, let's look at other countries that have had problems with doping.
A lot is going to come. I'm really scared for Kenya, actually, because the roof might just be coming down the house, you know. And even in Kenya, you remember months back, the star athletes started protesting issues about systemic doping, issues about corruption, endorsement money. Nobody knows how the money was spent. A lot of things happened. So there needs to be a cleanup. There needs to be a cleanup in the IAAF. And I hope that...